Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. From this video onwards, I'll be starting with new chapter based on data link layer. Data link layer is a layer 2 of OSI model, as well as when it comes to TCP/IP model, in that also data link layer is layer number 2. First, I'll explain you how many things that is been done by data link layer. After that, I'll explain you how many protocols that we will be going to study in this chapter along with data link layer. So, as I have told you, in OSI model, data link layer, that is layer number 2 that you can observe over here. And here, what will happen is network layer that will be giving packets to data link layer. So, input to this data link layer will be packet. And output of data link layer, that will be frames. Now, how frames are getting formed, that is based on what are the information that is added by data link layer. So, to form frames, data link layer will add physical address of source and destination, right? So, you see, data link layer forms frames from the packet, and data link layer will be adding what? It will be adding source and destination MAC address. MAC address is a physical address. So, MAC address of source and destination, that is been added at data link layer to form frame from the packet, right? So if you see here, format of frame is shown. So inside frame, how many informations are there? You see MAC address of source, MAC address of destination, and this is packet. So in packet we have source IP, destination IP, and segment, and here a tail is added along with packet to form frame, right? So inside data link layer we are adding few additional information which is based on MAC address of source and destination and tail, right? Now let us try to understand how many tasks that is been performed by data link layer. So these are the essential tasks like access to the media, media access control, error detection and collision, and few optional tasks are there like flow control and an acknowledgement. See, this optional task that is also available in few models like TCP/IP model. So you will be observing in TCP/IP model, flow control and acknowledgement, that is managed at data link layer only, right? But here I have mentioned that as per optional. Why? The reason is these are not the task which is there with all the models. But still, I'll explain you each and every task along with great detail in this video. So let us see first how media, access to the media is there. So access to the media means what? So basically, when it comes to computer network, there are three categories of media that you will be using in general, like fiber optic media, wireless media, or copper media. In copper media, you will be providing signaling as per electrical signal. In fiber optic media, you will be providing signaling as per light signal. And in wireless media, we provide signaling as per electromagnetic waves. So that access to the media along with signaling, that is being managed at data link layer, right? So this is one task that is being performed by data link layer. Access to the media. So which kind of media is accessed over here, based on that signaling will be done. So that control mechanism that is there at data link layer. Second task, that is media access control. So media access control means what? See, once you provide signaling on the media, means you will be sending data on the media, right? But when you send the data on the media, at that time there should be error free communication. Error free communication means data should not get lost on the media, or there should not be any collision on the media. So that control will be done by data link layer, right? So simultaneous access to the media may incur collision of frames on the media. So that collision, that we need to avoid. And that control mechanism that is been done by data link layer, like see, timings of the frame on the transmission is managed at data link layer. Now let me give you an example of how timings that should be managed. So for that, here I'm showing you one bus topology example. So in bus topology, see, with this center Ethernet cable, many nodes are connected, right? You can observe over here. Now let us consider we want to have a communication in between 1 to 5, means this node to this node, and 3 to 4 means this node to this node. Now, as if simultaneous communication is happening, then what will happen? You see, then this electrical signals that will get collide with each other. The reason is, in this bus topology, this single wire will be transmitting information with each other. So, as if at the same time, if 1 and 3 both are sending signals to their nodes, then what will happen? It will damage the data. It will not damage cable, right? It will damage the data. So, as if data is getting corrupted, then error-free communication is not possible, right? So, timings of the frames, like first it will tell it to node number 1, you can send the signal to 5. After completion of that data transfer, it will allow 3 to have access with node number 4, right? See, this is what the timing which will be defined by data link layer. For that, there are few interesting protocols that I am going to cover in this playlist. And third interesting task, that is error detection and collision. So, in my video of OSI model also, I have told you, when it comes to data link layer, we will be adding tail bits, and that we added for error detection over here, right? So, for error free transmission, it is very essential that we should identify errors are there in frame or not, and that is been managed at data link layer. There are few optional tasks even, like flow control, right? But this optional task of flow control, that is also there inside TCP/IP model. So, what is flow control? See, flow control means when transmitter and receiver are communicating with each other at a time, speed of communication that should be well managed. Like for example, if transmitter is transmitting data at 10 Mbps, but receiver can handle up to 1 Mbps only, then what will happen? Receiver will have to tell it to transmitter, you should lower down the speed of communication, then only receiver can handle that traffic forwarded by transmitter, right? So, that is referred as flow control. For example, as if transmitter is sending with 10 Mbps speed, but receiver can manage 100 Mbps speed, then receiver again will tell transmitter, you can increase speed up to 100 Mbps, right now you are slow. So, that is referred as flow control. One another optional task, that is acknowledgement, that is managed at data link layer. Like you see, here we are having one transmitter, and transmitter is sending one frame to receiver. So, once that frame is received at receiver side, receiver will give feedback to transmitter in terms of acknowledgement, right? It tells transmitter that this frame is received properly over here. If frame is not received properly, then receiver will give acknowledgement based on you will have to send this frame again. The reason is that frame have been lost somewhere in the medium. So, that is how acknowledgement process is there, that is also managed at data link layer, right? Now, there are few basic things that you need to understand. Like data link layer, that is bisected into two sub layers. This is logical division, right? Like logical link sub layer and media access control sub layer. At logical link sub layer, flow control, acknowledgement and error notification, that is been managed. And at media access control sub layer, which node will access to the media using MAC address, that is been defined by data link layer at this sub layer, right? So, that is how logically there are two parts of data link layer. And MAC address, that you should know, it is unique 12 digit alphanumeric address. Technically, it is not alphanumeric, it is hex address, right? And it is having size of 48 bits. For example, with any computer, there can be Wi-Fi card or network interface card for MAC address. Now, let me tell you how many topics that I'm going to cover in this entire chapter. So, this chapter is based on data link layer, in which you'll be observing, I'll be discussing about protocols based on flow control. I'll be explaining you protocols based on multiple access, protocols based on error control, as well as how framing is happening. So, all those topics that I am going to cover in this chapter of data link layer inside complete chapter of computer network. Still, if anything that you would like to share in front of me, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.